Hi, I'm Michelle Taylor, LPCC here. Today I want to talk about what is holistic therapy. I have been reading How to Do the Work by Nicola Pera, which is the holistic psychologist on Instagram. She's gained a lot of popularity over the past couple of years. Really like her stuff. Check her book out. It's on the bestsellers list. It's pretty cool. But what she talks about in the first couple of chapters is holistic psychology. And as I was listening to it, I was like, you know, I haven't really gone into what that means with people on my Instagram. And I just kind of wanted to give you the 101 version of what it is. So I'm a CBT therapist, which means I'm a cognitive behavioral therapist. So a lot of my clients will come in and it's very structured work. We try to figure out what your belief system is, and then we restructure it to help you change what your behaviors are. So whatever you think about yourself is what you're going to feel, and then you're going to have behaviors that follow it. So it's based off of that cognitive triangle. But the more that I'm working with coaching clients, I'm realizing that I want to be more of an integrative, holistic therapist. And what that means is to infuse some of the stuff that I use with my coaching clients with some of the stuff that I've learned as a cognitive behavioral therapist. Because we don't want to think of the mind and the body as two separate things. They coexist together. They function best with each other rather than against each other. So, you know, sometimes you go to a heart doctor to fix the heart. You go to a lung doctor to fix the lungs. You go to a brain doctor to fix the brain. But in therapy, when you use a holistic approach, which is what Dr. LaPera says, you use what you know that works with the body. How does the body maintain itself its best way so that the mind and the soul can work its best as well? And the same thing, when you work on your mind, your body will work well. So it's a holistic, integrative approach rather than just working on your mind. So reason why I think this is so important to talk about today is because I've posted a lot of things recently about body work and the importance of maintaining your fundamentals, which if you haven't looked at some of my past posts, the fundamentals are eat right, sleep well, move every day, breathe, do your breath work, focus / be present, celebrate, and prosper. And when you focus on these fundamentals daily, you will start to feel better mentally and physically and emotionally. And a lot of people I don't know if it's like they don't like thinking about it that way or if it's a shameful approach, but I've had some people with a little bit of resistance to that idea, that if you walk more daily, you're going to feel better. If you sleep more, 8 to 9 hours a night, you're going to feel better. Your emotions and your depression and your anxiety will reduce. And the research is unequivocally there. It is telling us that when you eat, sleep, move right every day, your brain will function better. It will send you the hormones and the stuff that you need in order to feel its best. And when you're not doing those fundamental basic things, you're not going to feel well. So with clients who come in and they have high anxiety, high depression, the first thing that I do with them is I ask them, what about your fundamentals? What are you doing? Are you eating right? Are you sleeping? Are you moving? Tell me about those habits. What are your behaviors in those areas? And we kind of just look at what are the patterns. Usually people who have high anxiety or high depression are staying up late. They're not getting 8 to 9 hours of sleep, and our brain needs to recharge. It's like a snow globe. It's shaken up all day. It needs time to settle. And if you're not sleeping enough, you're definitely not going to have a good day the next day. You're not going to make good eating choices. You're not going to make good working out choices. So I consider sleeping my number one fundamental, but a lot of people don't. And I remember when I didn't. The more I make my sleep protocol, my sleep habits, my number one priority, the better I am in making decisions the next day. My brain is able to do that. So sleep habits are really, really important when we talk about holistic therapy. Your eating habits, if you read any sort of books about diet and how it affects the body, I mean, we eat a lot of processed foods in general as a society. And your gut, watch Netflix, watch Human on Netflix. It's wonderful. Awesome. You'll learn a lot about your immune system and how your gut carries a lot of good bacterias that help fight back bad bacteria. And when you kill it by eating really bad foods, by things that just break your lining, which is where 90% of your serotonin is held and created, you're gonna feel bad. And so if you think about when you've eaten crappy or you've drank a lot of alcohol or just basically poisons for your body, you're gonna feel bad. You're gonna have anxiety hangovers, you're gonna have depressive symptoms because you feel lethargic. You're not getting those hormones passed through your body. And then finally, with movement. I posted the other day that they found that the magical number to help your cortisol move through your body better, which is the stress hormone, when we feel anxious or depressed, you have a lot of cortisol. The magical number of steps that you need to walk a day is 5,500 steps. And they found that the average American only walks 4,700 steps a day. So it kind of coincides with why our society has a high rate of anxiety and depression, because we're not moving the cortisol through our body. It's just sitting in there. Cortisol is great. We want cortisol because it helps us put into action. But when we're just sitting with it in our bodies, it's not healthy. It just sits and stresses out your body and you feel tired. So again, going back to tired, you need the right amount of sleep. Your eating and your movement definitely change your physiology of your body so that your brain works at its best. So I'm really hyped up about holistic psychology. I love the book. I love the concept. I love integrative therapy. To use what I know in CBT therapy and relationship work with physiological stuff that we can do to better ourselves. And if you don't look at your fundamentals, if you don't look at that part of why you're feeling anxious or depressed, you're doing it wrong. It really all works together. You really need to, if you go see a therapist, awesome, great. You're doing one part of the big picture. You need to also look at your eating, your sleeping, your moving, your breath work, because breath, we often shallow breathe all day and your brain needs 60% of that oxygen that you're breathing in. And if you're only doing shallow breathing, your brain is only getting like 50% of what it should be getting to function at its best. So doing some deep breath, filling the lungs, pushing out the carbon dioxide, making sure that all your cells get the great oxygenation that it needs to function really well. Whew, I get excited about this stuff. But if you're really interested and you're a nerd like me, check out Netflix Human. There's six episodes about the different systems of your body. Oh man, our bodies are just so awesome and so cool. We wanna treat it right so that our brains function at its best. And when you come into therapy, you kind of do that quadruple whammy where you're taking care of your mind, your body, and your soul. And you're helping yourself get rid of old thoughts, old beliefs that you used to have about yourself. So I don't think there's just one approach. I don't think it's all about diet. I don't think it's all about exercise. I don't think it's all about sleep. I don't think it's all about therapy. It's all combined. And so if you're interested in working with me, you know, contact us. We have a couple of holistic integrative therapists. And if you want to know more, definitely check out Nicola Perra's book. It's really great. And look into holistic psychology. It is really good stuff. So I hope that clears some things up. It was the 101 version of holistic psychology, integrative therapy. And I'll see you next time.